So as we celebrate July 4th weekend, I commend you for exercising your religious freedom. If you don't use it, you're going to lose it. Exercise your religious freedom. What we are doing right now, you're aware, this is illegal in parts of the world. If you become a Christian, you're arrested and even executed. Missionaries are expelled, and you're not allowed to build Christian churches. This is happening right now. So religious freedom is a great, great right. Exercise it. And also, the 20th century, which we just concluded, there were more Christians put to death for their faith, Orthodox, Catholic, Protestant Christians, more Christian martyrs in the 20th century than the first 19 centuries put together. That's how bad it was in the 20th century. So religious freedom is very, very precious. And what the gospel is saying is that all of us are missionaries, everybody. All of us are sent to prepare the way of the Lord like John the Baptist. These 72 were not apostles. They were disciples like us, followers of Christ. And he sent them out saying that they were going to be laborers in the harvest. All of us are missionaries. And carry no money bag, no sack. That would be luggage, no luggage. No sandals, you're going to go barefoot. This really is a biblical way of saying boot camp. Paris Island. This is what this is. You learn not to depend on your money or your belongings. You go barefoot, you've got to depend on the Lord. You've got to depend on God. And you learn that at boot camp. And that's what this is all about. And we bring peace to those we meet. We offer them God's peace. And when they bring us into their homes, it says, eat and drink what is offered to you. I do that very well. Eat what is set before you. Cure the sick and say to them, the kingdom of God is at hand. Now, we're all missionaries. Where would you like to be a missionary? Would you like to go to Africa? Would you like to go to Asia? Where would you like to go to be a missionary? Well, there's been a survey of the 50 states that make up our country. Those that are most religious and those that are least religious. So the question is, what is your religious affiliation? Are you Jewish? Are you Catholic? Are you Protestant? Are you a Muslim? Are you a Hindu? What is your religious affiliation? And some people said, nothing. I'm nothing. They have no religious affiliation. They don't identify with any faith. Even if you were to say, well, I'm a Catholic, I only go a couple of times a year, at least you're identifying as a Catholic. But many people just said, I'm nothing. Can anybody tell me what state in the Union has the most people who have no religious affiliation? Nothing. Vermont! Vermont! Right over here, Vermont! 37% of Vermonters have no religious affiliation. Nothing. You know who's number two? New Hampshire! 36! We're as bad as they are. 36% of our neighbors, 36%, that's like 3 or 4 out of every 10 people we meet, have no religion, no religious affiliation. They identify with nothing. They believe in nothing. Nothing. They're nuns. We call them nuns, okay? Nothing. Yeah. Massachusetts, I know you're out there. You're here. 32% of the Bay State, nothing. Nothing. 32%. Maine, 32%, the same as Massachusetts. Rhode Island, 30%. What I'm telling you is, folks, that we're in mission territory. We don't have to go to Africa or Asia. We're in mission territory. New England is the least religious part of the United States. We ain't the Bible Belt. We're not. We have more people with no church, no synagogue, no affiliation. And now I got to tell you something. I think it's a great opportunity. Look at all of us here. I think it's a great opportunity to invite people to come with us here. Imagine if we were in a state that had 98% of the people had a church. Well, you'd only have 2% of the people that you'd be trying to mission to. We got 36% right here in New Hampshire. And so I want to encourage you folks, really, these are good people. We've got the best people in the country. We got the best people in the world. These are good people. They're created in the image and likeness of God. God loves them. Jesus is their Savior. They're good people. In that gospel, we offer them friendship. We offer them peace. We don't yell at them. We don't badger them. We invite them. Befriend them, folks. Befriend them. And when the opportunity arises, when the topic comes up, invite them here. We have a wonderful RCIA. And Linda Hilton, who's our lector, she's right here. You want to talk to her after Mass. If you know of anybody, really, that has no church, invite them to come here. We're prepared to welcome them. We're prepared to get them ready for the sacraments. We're talking about adults. We're talking about teenagers. We're talking about whole families can come into the church and share our faith. The thing is, you know, without any religion, without any faith, they're missing out. They are missing out. Yesterday, look at these flowers. We had a beautiful wedding. I couldn't take, they were so beautiful, I had to leave them up. Someone said they're so beautiful, they look artificial. Look at this. But you have the church filled. We had a full mass, a nuptial mass. The parents, the grandparents, the bride, everybody was thrilled. Everybody came up for communion. Those who weren't communicants, I blessed each one of them. It just was, you're really missing out. They're missing out if they don't have any faith at all. So we're doing mission work in New Hampshire, folks. We're missionaries right here. So I'm encouraging you, invite them here. And finally, when someone dies, and we all do. When someone dies and they have no church, they have no minister, they have no priest, we'll take care of them here. Bring them here. No one should die without having some type of a ceremony. Nobody should die without some type of faith and prayer over them. Nobody should. So you bring them here, okay? So we're doing mission work. I can't believe it. We're doing